Hello, everybody. Now I will be introducing to you the Belgian Baby Blue Bull Cow, also known as the BBBC by Quinn Gorman. Overview. Genetic modification is fairly new to our society, with the first successful test in 1973. In today's 2020, we have the ability to conduct genetic modification in a more humane and natural way. Over the past few decades, scientists and farmers have created a way to genetically modify a species of cow that used selection breeding without any steroids or chemicals. This is known as the Belgian Blue Bull Cow. It seems great when you think about it. Producing more muscle, meat, no harsh additives, strictly natural. But when you take a look at the cow, you can't just help but wonder, is there something inhumane or dangerous about this breed? In the bottom picture, we see the Belgian Blue Bull Cow in 1980, weighing over 1,800 pounds. But if you look up, we see the Belgian Blue Bull Cow in the year 2015, weighing 2,700 pounds. Now that's a lot of meat. This picture right here is the Belgian Blue Bull Cow. This beast weighs so much, and the amount of muscle mass that these cows have gives the species a condition called hypoplasia. So this condition affects the cows where their organs and tissues don't grow and mature completely because the muscle mass takes over their whole bodies. Yes, the farmers are killing less cattle. And yes, this is designed somewhat all natural, but after 50 years of breeding and rapidly increasing weight each and every year, this process has become pretty dangerous. This was a fascinating discovery from Professor Handset. Both names were in two different articles. His ideas and way of using genetic modification in a respectful and safer way were totally spot on. After many years of people breeding the Belgian Blue Bull, his ideals started to fade away, and the bulls became bigger and more painful. Now, it is impossible for the cow to give natural birth. Each cow must have a C-section as they become increasingly more massy. We can't let Professor Handset's ideas and ideals go away. We need to renounce this species of the Belgian Blue Bull and bring the cow back down to the original state that the cows could remain healthy and stop this debilitating disease of hypoplasia. This would once again give us the pride of creating the Belgian Blue Bull Cow with the Belgian Baby Blue Bull Cow. Thank you for your time.